Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to start with the second unit, that is self-management. What do you mean by self-management? Self-management is an individual skill to control feelings, emotions, and activities. It plays a decisive role in our personal and our professional life. What is the importance of this self-management, students? The importance of self-management plays a very vital role in our life. It makes us more organized and it becomes easier to work. With skills, you get a chance to work better and have better chance of being successful. It helps you to give more productive output and values to the organization. It gives you the confidence to control all the situations and the success or failure of your task. Self-management is also very important in the aspects of your studies as well. See, there are different components of the self-management. You cannot be self-managed within one day. So which all components are responsible for making you self-balanced, self-managed? Okay, we'll have a turn towards knowing which all components are essential for self-management. First point is self-control and self-confidence. Now, just we need to know what do you mean by confidence. Confidence is not something that can be learned or like a set of rules. Confidence is a state of mind, positive, practice, training, knowledge, and talking to others. People are all useful ways to help improve or boost your confidence level. So confidence is the first component for building your self-management. Second point is self-awareness. You need to know your positives and negatives. Self-awareness is a valuable skill that very fewly can master in. It takes years of efforts to achieve the self-awareness. Next component is self-development. Now, what do you mean by self-development? Self-development means developing your own horizons, knowing your own limitations, your own responsibilities, and trying to progress in your own limitations. Self-motivation. What is self-motivation? Trying to always be positive, know yourself and think positively, learn from mistakes, dream, dare to have big dreams. Find different sources of motivation and inspiration, reading books, listening to music, conducting activities, taking initiatives. This all comes under self-motivation. Next component which we are going to learn is positivity. You always need to be positive. Don't allow negative thoughts to get entered in your mindset, which will try to spoil out your all self-esteem. Next, we are going to turn towards initiative. You always need to do a work with your own initiative. You don't need to wait till anyone orders you. So initiative always helps you for self-esteem and for self-management. Next is productivity. What is productivity? Whatever task has been allotted for you, whatever task you're supposed to complete, you need to be productive. You need to come to the conclusion of that task with 100% of your dedication. The next component which is essential for self-management is stress management. So what is stress? Stress is something which is ruining your life. Stress can be physical, internal, or external. Stress again are categorized as negative and positive stress. So to overcome through the stress, there are various stress relieving techniques like exercising daily, going in nature's walk, getting enough sleep, stay away from conflict, listening to music, changing the surroundings, trying to change the lifestyle with the acceptance of different hobbies, eating healthy food. This all will help you to retrieve from the stress. Next component is organization. A person who needs to be self-esteem, self-managed, first need to organize all his life and work according to his plan. Everything should be well planned so that it becomes very easy to overcome all the tasks. Next point is accountability. What is accountability? Accountability means you should be always clear with facts and figures. You should be responsible for whatever task has been allotted and completing it on the given allotted time with the account management. Next is, what are the factors which help in building the self-confidence? Which all factors will help you for building up your self-confidence? The way you dress up, your attitude, your body language, eye contact, position in life, motivation, non-verbal signs, communication skills, grooming, speech level, and your mood. These factors are again broadly categorized into social factor, cultural factor, and physical factor. So what is social factor? Social factor deals with how you deal with the society. See, if you want people to like you, you need to be with the people, you need to allot time to the people, you need to be a bit social, try to help out the society. Second one is cultural factor. Culture is the lifeblood of vibrant society. Expressed in many ways, we tell our stories, celebrate, remember the past, entertain ourselves. This all comes under cultural factors. So you need to be responsible to give something back to your society with the help of your culture. Third one is physical factor. What is physical factor? You need to be physically strong and mentally healthy. So exercise has a powerful effect on confidence. Regular exercise relaxes mental stress and body and brain work properly. Then there are few more factors which are responsible for building up your self-confidence. They are as talking yourself up, get a hobby, avoid arrogance, set some goals, always play to your strength, improve your weakness, always be positive, don't accept failure and get rid of negative voice in your head. So students, today we have learned how to manage the self-esteem. So what is self-management? What is self-confidence? Self-awareness? Self-development? We have seen all the factors which are responsible for developing self-confidence. Now you are requested to go through the notes, go through the presentation, try to solve the exercise in our computer notebook. Okay, bye, have a good day.